Welcome to another video in the Getting Started with SAP S/4HANA playlist. In the last video, we have seen how to download and install SAP GUI and how to add the SAP server connection details, then how to connect to the server. In the video today, we are going to see how to connect to an SAP server using SAP Fiori through any web browser without installing any special apps. So in this video, I'm going to show you a demo on how to set up your Windows device to connect to SAP Fiori. And in the next video, I'm going to show you how to set up your Mac device. Before starting the video, I want to thank the SAP team for sending the new SAP champion jersey. I am really happy that I finally received it. As you see, this time it is blue. Last time it was gray. So this is the one I received in 2022, and I have been using it since then in many of my videos. So from now on, I'm also going to use this one. This one is blue, which is much nicer in front of the camera, and also the color is really nice. So I'm really happy that I finally got this one. And I'm really proud to be recognized by SAP as an SAP community champion, having a positive impact on the community. I have learned a lot of things from everyone, and it is really my duty to share my knowledge as much as I can. Now let's start with our demo and see how we can set up Windows devices to connect to SAP Fiori.
Internal accounting entries and everything.
The SAP business process integration is for HANA. In the last video, we have seen what is SAP GUI. So this is the application that we downloaded, then installed. And I have added my SAP server connection details here. So if I double click on the connection details, it will open the login screen. Then I can insert a username, a password, then press enter. And we are connected to the server. The same thing we can do from any web browser using SAP Fiori. So if I switch here to Google Chrome, and then I can go to this tab, this is SAP Fiori. Before I explain to you how to set it up on your device, I wanted to show you how it looks like. So this is SAP Fiori, and here we have different applications or tiles that we can use to process the different transactions. Anything that we can do in SAP GUI, we can also do in SAP Fiori, but we cannot configure the system. So for SAP consultants to configure SAP, we must use SAP GUI. But for the end users who process normal business transactions, any transaction that can be done on SAP GUI can also be done in SAP Fiori. This is why many organizations have actually replaced GUI completely with Fiori and don't allow their employees to access SAP GUI. Because SAP Fiori is more modern, it has a lot of features that do not exist in SAP GUI, so it is more visual. So here we can have graphs, the pages or the applications look much nicer. We have a lot of options that are not available in SAP GUI. And also it can work on any device. So it can work on your tablet, cell phone, laptop, PC, any device with a web browser, you can use it to open SAP Fiori. There are many other advantages. I'm not going to get into the details here. I just want to explain to you how to set up SAP Fiori in your device. So this is how SAP Fiori looks like. Now to be able to access this website or web page, as you see here, we have an address. And this address must be provided to you by the SAP server provider. So normally, if you subscribe to an SAP server for training or for learning, you are going to ask the provider for a link to access SAP Fiori. And before you even subscribe, you have to confirm with the provider that SAP Fiori is configured and is active on the server. So for example, in my AG SAP server access for SAP S/4HANA 2023, I do have SAP Fiori that's fully configured and activated, and anyone who subscribed to my server can go ahead and use SAP Fiori. So first you need to confirm before subscribing that SAP Fiori is active and configured, and then you can ask for the link to connect to SAP Fiori. If you cannot find the link or if no one provides you the link, it is very easy to get this link yourself. If SAP Fiori is configured, then all you need to do is to go to SAP GUI. So first you start by installing SAP GUI and then adding the SAP server connection details, and then you open the server, and then from here you go to the transaction box and you insert /n/UI2/FLP. This code is fixed and is the same in any SAP server. So any SAP system that has SAP Fiori configured and installed, if you go to the transaction box and insert this transaction code and then press enter, it will open. It will ask you first to allow access to open this web page. Then you click on allow, and it will open the SAP Fiori portal as you see here. Now let me switch to SAP GUI, and I will tell you a very easy way to remember this transaction code. So first we have slash in, which opens a new transaction in the same screen. And then we have slash UI2, which stands for User Interface 2. And then we have slash FLB, which is Fiori Launchpad. So you have slash in slash User Interface 2 slash Fiori Launchpad. This is very easy to remember. And also you can easily add it to your favorite transactions. So you can right click here on favorites, then click on insert transaction. And here you insert slash UI2 slash FLP. Enter, and this will add the transaction to your favorites. So whenever you double click here, it will ask you for permission. You can also click on remember my decision, so next time it will go directly to the web page, and then you click on allow and it will take you to the Fiori Launchpad. Now we understand how to get the link that we are going to use to connect to SAP Fiori, and this is the first step we have to do. But before we can connect to this link, we have to add a certain entry to the hosts file in Windows. Let me show you how to do this. So the hosts file is a file that exists in the same place on all Windows systems. And if you don't know the location of this file, you can easily search for it on any search engine. So if I press here on the Windows button and then I will insert hosts file location, enter. So as you see here, the first result I get is in Windows, you can find the hosts file in C Windows System 32 drivers etc hosts. This is a fixed place. So if I copy this, and then go to Windows Explorer. You can insert it here. So slash Windows slash System32 slash driver slash etc slash and then enter. You'll find yourself in this folder. And here we have the hosts file. If you are not able to find the file, then maybe you need to show the hidden items. So to do this, you click on view and then go to show hidden items. Now I need to edit this file to add a certain line. To do this, I will right click here and then click on open with and Notepad++. So this is an open source Notepad application that I love using. It has a lot of features that don't exist in the normal Notepad. So this is the one I use. You can download it easily from, you can go to Google, search for Notepad++. It is an open source application that's free. So I really recommend that you download it and use it. It's much better than Notepad. You can also use the normal Notepad. So if I double click here, let's use the normal Notepad. So here is my host's file. And this is the line that allows me to connect to SAP Fiori. I already have it added. This is why I was able to show you how SAP Fiori looks like in the beginning of the video. But normally this line is not here and you have to add it yourself. So let me tell you what this line is. First, we start by inserting the application server of the SAP system. And this is what is provided to us by the SAP server provider. And this is the same one that we added in SAP GUI in the last video. So if I switch here to SAP GUI, and if I go to the SAP server connection details, go to properties, here we have the application server. So this is the same one that we use here. So you are going to copy this one. So let's say, for example, I'm going to add a new line. So you paste this line here and then press space. And then here you insert this part from the web address that we use to connect to SAP Fiori. So if I go to Google Chrome, here is the SAP Fiori Launchpad. I am going to copy this part. So after https://, then we have this part. So this is what I'm going to copy. This can be different for each SAP server. So you have to copy it exactly from the link that you have in your web browser. I'm going to copy this part and then go back to the hosts file and paste it. So this is the line that allows me to connect to this SAP Fiori Launchpad. First, we have the application server, then space, then we have this part from the web address. By the way, this application server is fake, so don't try to connect to SAP Fiori using it because it will not work. I just added it here for this demo. And then we need to save the hosts file, so we can press on Control S or go to File, Save. And the Notepad is going to ask us to save it in another file with TXT extension. Why? Because we cannot edit the hosts file unless we are administrators on the device and we have Notepad open in administrator mode. This is why we cannot save to the hosts file itself. We have to open Notepad as administrators. So if you try to save, it will save it in another file, .txt, which wouldn't do anything because you have to save it in the same file that we have here. So to do this, we need to open Notepad as administrators. So now let me show you how to do this. So if I go here to start and then go to Notepad, right click, and then here we have run as administrator, and then here go to file, open, and we insert the the place where we can find the hostess file. So this is the same location we used in the Windows Explorer. So we have Windows, System 32, drivers, etc. And then here you go and choose all files, and you are going to find hosts. So double click on hosts, it will open the file. And now we can edit the hosts file as we want and then save. So this is how we can add this line to the hosts file to be able to connect to the Fiori Launchpad using this web address for this application server. If you have different SAP servers, then you need to add a line for each server, same as we did here. There is one more thing I would like to add. So the first time you connect to the Fiori link from any web browser, you are going to get a warning that the connection is not private, and this is completely normal. So for example, if I go now to Google Chrome and copy this link, then try to open it in Edge. This is the first time I open this link in Edge. So I'm going to insert the link here, enter. I will get this message, so your connection is not private. So this is completely normal. So what I need to do is click on Advanced and then click on Continue to S4HANA 2023. So this link can be different for each person. So click on Continue and then it will take you to the page to log into SAP Fiori. So here you can insert the username, password, and go on. And this is how you can set up your Windows device to connect to SAP Fiori Launchpad. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to do this for MacBook. If you would like to get access to an SAP S4HANA 2023 system to test the different business processes, configure the system yourself, connect to SAP Fiori and try it, then you can subscribe to my SAP S4HANA 2023 server. You can find all the details in this link. Thank you for watching. I hope you found the video useful. Don't forget to share it with your connections. Subscribe to the channel to be notified when I publish new videos. Also, leave me your comments. Tell me what you think of this video and if there is anything else you would like me to add to this playlist. If you'd like to support the channel, you can also check the channel membership program, which will allow you also to get access to the member exclusive videos and our document library, where I share different configuration documents and many other files. Thank you for watching, and I will see you again soon.